Hi there guys, and welcome to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be setting up our own Minecraft server on Unraid and then linking that server through to a domain name so our friends can easily connect to the server and play. Sounds interesting? Then let's get started. So I'd say pretty much everyone nowadays has heard of the game Minecraft. It started its life in 2009 as a paid public alpha for PCs, eventually being properly released in November 2011. And today in 2021, it's still a massively popular online game. There are two different flavours of Minecraft. There's the Minecraft Java Edition, which runs only on PCs. And there's the Minecraft Bedrock Edition, which is cross-platform. Now, full disclosure here, I don't really play Minecraft very often, and the only version I've actually played is the Java version myself, but from what everyone tells me, the Java version is far superior to the Bedrock version, and in this video, the Minecraft server we're going to be setting up is going to be only for the PC Java version. Now, maybe in the future I'll make another video for setting up a Bedrock server, but for now, it's just going to be the Java one. Now yeah, of course you don't need your own Minecraft server to play Minecraft, so why go to the trouble of setting one up? Well, normally when you play Minecraft just as it is, there's limitations on how you can play. But when you have your own Minecraft server, you can design the world however you like and you choose the rules of that world. You control everything, from physics, landscapes, spawn rates, you control it all. And when you're running your own server, you can install any mods that you want. And once you've set up your Minecraft server, you can invite your friends to play by putting in the address of the Minecraft server and joining your world. And so in this video, after we've set up our Minecraft server, I'm going to show you how to connect it to a domain name. Then people will be able to connect to your server using an address like minecraft.yourserver.com. So then the name's easy to give out and easy to connect to. No remembering any IP addresses or any nonsense like that. But you don't actually have to expose your Minecraft server to the internet if you don't want to. You can just run it locally and then have people inside your own house on your own network connect to the server and use it from there. Now if you do want to connect your Minecraft server to the internet so you can share it with your friends, this video assumes that you've bought your own domain name and that domain name is running through the Cloudflare service. So if you don't know how to do that, then please see my beginner's core topic video, which will show you how to get that done. And if you don't have a static internet WAN IP address, then you're going to need some sort of DNS tracker. And you can see how to set that up in this video here. Now, of course, it goes without saying that to follow along with this video, it's expected you're doing this on an Unraid server. But of course, you can set up a Minecraft container on any Linux system with Docker installed. And of course the last thing you're going to need is you're going to need the Minecraft software running on a PC. Okay, so that's what we need for this project, so let's make a start, go across to the Unraid server and install a container. So let's head on over to the Apps tab and do a search for Minecraft. Now we're going to use one of Binhex's excellent containers. We're going to use the Binhex Minecraft server here. Now I'm not installing the Minecraft Bedrock server, just the standard Minecraft one here. So click onto the little button to install. So let's scroll down here and look at the template. Now for now, everything here we can leave as default. But we're going to need to put in a password for the web UI. For me, I'm just going to use a really unsafe password called password, so you know you're probably going to want something a bit better than that. So that's all we need to put in for the time being. So with that done, let's click on to apply and pull down the container and click done. And so now if we go back to the Docker tab, we can see here that the Minecraft server's running. So if we click onto it and go to web UI, and here we just log in with the username and password from inside the template. So admin and password. Then you're probably going to get this message here. There is no screen to be attached matching Minecraft. Now this is perfectly normal the first time the container started up. So we just need to close this window and go back to the Docker tab. So what we need to do is to restart the Minecraft server. And then once it's restarted, we can go back to the web UI. Now we can see the world's generating and everything's good. Okay, so the server's up and running. So now we want to go across onto a computer where we've got the Minecraft game installed. So here I am on a Windows 10 gaming VM, and once the game started up, just click onto multiplayer. Just agree to this and proceed. Now it will actually start scanning your local network looking for a game server, but I find this never actually works. So we need to add it manually to test it. And for that we need the IP address of the server that the Minecraft container is running on, and the port number. And you can check what that is by going onto the Docker page, and you'll see it under binhex Minecraft server under the port mappings. My server IP address is 10.10.20.198, and the port number the Minecraft server is running on is 25565. So back on the Minecraft client, we want to now click on to add server, and we need to name the server. I'm just going to call it Minecraft server local network because this is a test one. And then under server address, we want to put in the server IP and the port number 25565, and then click on done to add that server. We can see that it's available because we can see the kind of green status kind of thing that looks like a cell phone signal status. And then to connect to that particular server, just click onto it and you should see it says connecting to server, then joining world. Okay, great. So I'm connected to the Minecraft server now. Let's just make it full screen. And when there's a connection to the Minecraft server, if we actually look at the web UI of the container, we can see when someone connects. So let's take a look at that now and then connect on with the Minecraft client at the same time. Right, so there we are at the bottom. We can see that I've connected on. You can see here it says that I've joined the game. And on the line above there, we can see the IP address and port number of the computer that's logged in. And as well, which is quite interesting, we can also see the entity ID. And also in the brackets here, that's the coordinates in the Minecraft world where the character is actually spawned. Okay, so because we can see a player here logging in on the actual Minecraft console screen, we know 100% sure that the server's working locally. So now the next step to do is to connect it to a domain name so that we can allow our friends over the internet to connect to the server too. So the first thing that we're going to have to do is go to our router and do a bit of port forwarding. Now the Minecraft server uses port 25565. So we need to make sure that this port is forwarded to the local IP address of our Unraid server. Okay, so here I'm on a basic Netgear router, and you normally find port forwarding in the advanced section. So on this router, I go to the advanced tab and then go down here to advanced setup. And if I scroll down here, I can see port forwarding and port triggering. So I'm going to click onto that. And here we can see at the moment, there's two port forwarding rules already here. On a lot of routers, you'll have like various different services that you can automatically select, but we're going to have to create our own service here. So I'm going to click on to add custom service. And for service name, I'm going to call it Minecraft. And the external starting port is 25565. And the ending port, the same, 25565, as it's only one port that we're forwarding here. And so here I need to put the port number that it's going to on the server. Again, I want that to be the same, 25565. And for service type, I'm going to leave it TCP UDP. And then I need to choose the IP address of the Unraid server. Now this router isn't actually mine, so this doesn't correspond to my earlier IP address that we were looking at. So we want to click on to apply. Okay, and so now we can see the rules here. The service name Minecraft. So the external, which means on the kind of internet side, the start and end port is 25565, and that's being forwarded through to the internal port, the same port number, 25565, going to the IP address here of the Unraid server. Okay, so that's the port forwarding all set up. Now remember, every router is slightly different. Yours will probably look different to this one. But what I'll do is I'll go onto my own router now, which is running pfSense, and just set it up there, just to show you it being set up on another router as well. So here I'm going to click onto firewall and then NAT, and it's already on the port forwarding page here. So I'm going to click onto the add button. The protocol here I'm going to set to TCP UDP, and the port obviously 25565 and 25565 for the end port. And in here I'm going to put the IP address of my Unraid server, which is 10.10.20.198. And I want it to forward to the same port. So again, 25565. Obviously the description, I'm going to call it Minecraft. And one last thing here on pfSense, I'm going to enable the NAT reflection. So what NAT reflection does is allow it when you're hosting the domain name on your own WAN IP, then the domain name will resolve even though it's being hosted on your own network. Now, not every single router does NAT reflection, so you may find when you've set up your Minecraft server that other people will be able to connect to your server through the actual domain address, but if you're inside your own network, you might have to use the local IP. Okay, so that's enough about port forwarding now. So once your port forwarding's all set up, it's time for us to connect the actual domain over to the server. Now you might be thinking that we're going to use some type of reverse proxy to do this, but a reverse proxy really is best suited for forwarding HTTP and HTTPS traffic only. So that's things on port 80 and 443. Now the Minecraft server is using port 25565. So that's not going to go through our reverse proxy. And so because we can't use a reverse proxy for this, that's why we set up the port forward rule a moment ago. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to Cloudflare and set up a subdomain there. I'm going to set up minecraft.yourdomain.1, and that's going to point through to my WAN IP on my network. But that alone will only get it half working. If I was to leave it like this, then people who wanted to connect to my Minecraft server would have to use the address minecraft.yourdomain.1, and then they'd have to specify the port number, so they'd have to put colon 25565. So yeah, whilst that'll work, it's really clunky, and we don't want to do it like that. We just want to be able to give out the domain of our Minecraft server just as minecraft.yourdomain.1. We don't want any port numbers on the end. And we can do that by adding what's called an SRV record to that subdomain. It will make the subdomain minecraft.yourdomain.1 push all of its traffic through TCP port 25565. So what exactly is an SRV record? Well, an SRV record is basically a symbolic name and the transport protocol used as part of the subdomain or domain name. It can define the priority, weight, port, and the target for the service in the record. So, as Arnold would say,
enough talk!
Let's head to Cloudflare and set it up. So, let's log into the domain and go to DNS. And now, if you followed my earlier video on setting up Cloudflare, you'll have seen me set up this subdomain so it tracks my WAN IP address. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a subdomain using a CNAME. And I'm going to call it Minecraft. And for the target, I'm going to make it point to this subdomain. So dynamic.yourdomain.1. And click on to save. Okay, so now I've got the subdomain set up for Minecraft, which by going through this subdomain is pointing to my IP. Okay, so the next thing to do is we're going to add the SRV record. So next, click on to add. And under type, scroll right down until you come to SRV. Click onto that. And now for the name, I'm going to call it Minecraft. And for the service, I'm going to put underscore and then Minecraft. The protocol, I want to be TCP. TTL, I'm going to leave as auto. And for priority, I'm going to put 0. Then under here, weight, I'm going to give it 5. And for port, that's the port number the Minecraft server uses. So that's port 25565. And then the target here, this needs to be my subdomain. So the target's going to be minecraft.yourdomain.1. Okay, so that's all we need. So let's click on to save. Now you can see here, because I've made the SRV record, that the subdomain minecraft.yourdomain.1, the IP address is exposed because of this. So because of that, I may as well go back here, click on to edit, and just unproxy this as well, and click save. Because whatever way around I have it, the real IP is going to be exposed with Minecraft. Okay, so that's all the DNS set up in Cloudflare now. So now let's go and actually test it out. Head back to the Windows PC and see if we can connect to the server with the domain name. Okay, so here we are back at the Minecraft client, and I'm going to add a new server. This one I'm going to call Minecraft server your domain, and the server address is minecraft.yourdomain.1. Okay, so now I can click on to done. Okay, we know it's connected because we've got the green status there. So let's click on here to connect. Okay, and here we are in the Minecraft server. So it's all working fine, straight through the domain using the SRV record. Okay, so before we wrap things up, now everything's working, let's just quickly have a look at a few ways we can improve the performance of the Minecraft server. And also, if any of our users are using a cracked Minecraft client, how we can allow them to be able to connect to the server. Okay, so just to finish off now, let's look at a couple of features of the container. So obviously, if we open the web UI, we come to the Minecraft console, and here we can type in various commands in to do with our server. If you type the word help, it will show you a whole bunch of things. Now, I'm not going to go through any of this at all. There's plenty of guides that are far better than I could explain on how to use the server. Now, if we go back to the Unraid server, and we look in the Minecraft server configuration folder, which is mapped to this location here in the appdata binhex Minecraft server in the Minecraft directory here with this file here, the file server properties. If we edit this, we can change a few things about the server. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a terminal window here and go into that directory by typing cd and then the directory path and press enter. I'm going to type ls just to list the files, and this is the file that I want to edit, the server.properties. And if I type nano and then server.properties and enter, you can see here there's various different things that we can change, such as the game mode at the moment is set for survival. Now, for those of us out there who are running our Minecraft server, and we got that one friend who's being really naughty using a crack version of Minecraft, and we want to be able to make sure that they can join the server, then we're going to have to change something here. And you see here where it says online mode equals true. Well, if we change that to false, our Minecraft server will still work online, but it will allow us to have clients that are running the crack version of Minecraft be able to connect to our server. So you just press Ctrl O to write out, and enter, and Ctrl X to exit. Okay, so let's close this now and go back to the Docker page. So obviously after making that change, we'd have to restart the container. But now let's go back to the actual Docker template and have a look at a few things here. Okay, so there's a few things I'm going to look at here, and just a few ways of being able to improve the performance of your Minecraft server. So at the moment, the max Java threads is set to 1. So obviously you can change that to however many threads you want to be able to use in your Minecraft server. I'm going to set that myself to 8, as I've got plenty of cores in my CPU. And also here, we've got Java initial heap size and Java max heap size. Now, depending on how much RAM you've got in your server, you may as well up these. I'm going to multiply mine by 4. So for initial heap size, I'm going to use 2048 megs. And for max heap size, I'm going to use 4096. So obviously that's 2 gigs and 4 gigs respectively. Okay, so I'm going to go down to the bottom of the page and click on to apply. And so by doing that, gives a lot more resources to the Minecraft server and should make it perform a bit better. Now obviously don't give it too much resources if you don't have much in your server. Just base it on what you have in your server and decide how much of those resources you want to be able to allow the Minecraft server to be able to use. Well, okay, I guess that brings us to the end of this video. Oh yeah, but I did say I'd be giving away a few copies of the Java version of Minecraft, and I'm going to be giving away 4 copies of the game. Now, don't worry if you've already got the game or you just don't want a copy of Minecraft if you win, then let me know and you can have an Amazon voucher for the same value instead. So if you want to be in with a chance to win, then please write down a Minecraft joke and write it in the comments of this video. So here's mine. Get it? Mine? Okay, I'll give you another one. That was pretty bad. If Facebook bought up Minecraft, what would they add to the game? A whole load of data so they could mine it. Okay, so to win a copy of Minecraft, your joke's got to be better than mine. But it's not going to be me who's judging how funny the joke is. Well, it's going to be you guys. So the 4 jokes that get the most thumbs up in the comments of this video, you're going to get a copy of Minecraft. Now, thinking about it, do you think we should only have Minecraft jokes in the competition? I don't know, I think it can be a joke, any video game based joke. Let's leave it at that. But please guys, try and keep them fairly clean, because YouTube just don't like comments that aren't. So the competition will run for 2 weeks, then after 2 weeks I'm going to make a video where I'll read out the best jokes and announce the winners, and that gives plenty of time for everyone to upvote the jokes and see which is the funniest. Okay guys, so well, it really is the end of the video now. If you're not a subscriber to the channel, please subscribe and give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. Now, as always, I want to say a huge thanks to all of my patrons and supporters out there. Thank you guys for supporting me. I really, really do appreciate it. Well, I guess that's it, and it's time for me to go. But whatever you're up to for the rest of the day, I hope it's good, and I'll catch you in the next video.